Hi, my name is Kiana. I'm 27 years old. I have two beautiful kids, a little girl and a little boy. I'm 6 months pregnant, gracefully. The beginning of this pregnancy, when I found out I was pregnant, I decided not to keep the baby. I had decided to, terminate pregnancy, which is a horrible word to use in the same sentence with pregnancy. I had, for that time, I had my boyfriend, which he is Catholic, and he just didn't wanna hear it. He didn't even comprehend the word abortion. He always says it's an ugly word, but I had made an appointment, and Teresa, you know, my boyfriend for that time, he knew who Teresa was, had met her before. He'd seen her at a store, and Teresa noticed him, decided to give him a card because Teresa had moved. Teresa had moved. I didn't know where the new place was. I didn't have her number. I didn't have no way of contacting her. But it's weird how God works, because not weird, just different. And he ended up bringing home the card. And for that time, I was already decided. I was so emotionally unstable, economically unstable. I just felt that it's no time to bring a baby into this world. I felt I wasn't ready for another baby. But ended up seeing Teresa, speaking to her. And I never would have thought me, Kiana, would ever think of having an abortion, of killing a baby. 'Cause that's the easiest way to say it, really. Just never thought that would even pass my mind. I never thought that would even be in my mind. Like, it's just, to this day, I'm still mad at myself for even thinking that. But I spoke to Teresa, and, you know, Teresa kind of seen it in my eyes that I was really gonna do it. I don't know how I was going to be able to live with myself. I guess I wasn't thinking about living with what I had, you know, would have done afterwards. I was just thinking of now. And, Teresa and I spoke for a while. And, she convinced me. She convinced me. I decided to keep the baby. I'm 6 months pregnant. And I can't wait to see their face when they're born. I'm ecstatic about it. I want to see him. It's going to be a boy. I want to see them, how they look for the first time, how they feel, hug them, feel them. I don't know. I I want to be there for him. I'm living. If you're watching this, obviously you're living. And if you're living, don't they have a right to live? They do. It's not their fault. They never asked to be brought into this world. If it is what it is, if you feel that you can't do this, God gave you this child for a reason. He might just be the next president, the next priest. Never know, but I tell you this, when you give birth, it's like you're breathing for the first time. It's great. If you feel that you're cornered, you feel that you have nowhere to go, there's resources out there. There's resources, there's places you can call, there's people you can see. There's places that will help you. And you just gotta be strong. You gotta hold on. You know, No one ever said life was gonna be easy. But I know it's worth it. And, you just gotta hold on. And this baby didn't ask to be put in this predicament. And he shouldn't have to be in that type of predicament. I'm 6 months pregnant. I'm still mad at myself for even thinking of terminating my pregnancy. I mean, who does that? Who can live with themselves after you? That's part of you. That's part of you. It has your blood running through their veins. Their heart beats. They feel. Can you imagine what they feel in that moment? It's unexplainable. And just hold on. You need help. You need anything. St. Gerard is a great place to go. They will help you with everything they can. You know, they will. They'll pray for you, and it's a good place. I was pregnant with my first daughter. I found this place, and it's great. And I love it. I love it. I come every Saturday because I can't come every other day because they're not open, but it's a good place. And you have to have faith. You have to be strong. And God gave you this baby for a reason. So if you're sitting there and you're looking at me right now and you're undecided whether keeping this baby, because it's a baby, it's not just a piece of meat or a glob of blood, it's a baby. And it has a right. He has a right. She has a right. The baby has a right. I say it again, and I can't say it enough. They did not ask to come into this world. But your responsibility is to make it as easy and comfortable for them coming into this world. And that's what a mother is. As a mother, you need to nurture. You need to know that this baby needs to be here. He needs you to survive. It's not. And you know, there's people out there, oh, you can do this. Oh, you'll be able to get farther, this. No. 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 If you was a female, you was there, you laid down, it's time to stand up. And I close it by saying, I pray that you do the right choice. Pick life. Just the way you love to live, the way you smile, the way you run, laugh, dance, pray, they have a right to do that. They have a right for a chance. They can't fight you from the womb. Give them a fighting chance. They deserve it, just like we have. Thank you.